Here to discuss that and a whole lot more is CBS News political contributor Molly Hooper. Molly, good morning.
Good morning.
It was a bit of a nail biter for me as I was watching this in real time, waiting to see which of the moderate senators might side with the Democrats. Did not have, well, two out of the four they expected went the direction that they were planning to. But where does this leave us in terms of the trial?
Well, what's going to happen last night, the Senate agreed to a schedule of sorts. They will return to business on Monday at 1 for closing arguments. Then they will break, but senators are going to have nearly 2 days to actually speak to the trial on the Senate floor. Keep in mind, these senators have been sitting for 3 weeks, yeah, not being able to say anything. And then on Wednesday afternoon, the full Senate will stand. Each member will say guilty, not guilty, when asked, should the president be impeached for abusing his power or obstructing Congress?
How long in session? So take us through Monday and Tuesday. What happens, how long they're going to be there for, and what they're going to be saying?
Okay. Monday, we're going to hear closing arguments for 4 hours, 2 hours apiece, by the White House Defense Counsel and the House managers. It's the time for them to wrap up their arguments, tie it in a bow, and essentially hand it to the Senate. That day, the Senate will, they will leave the quote-unquote impeachment court and go back into regular Senate session again so that senators can have 15 minutes apiece to speak to the American people and explain why they are voting the way they're voting. Then back in session, 4 p.m. Wednesday, and that's the time when we're all going to be watching to see what these senators say. And it's likely that they will acquit the president, but it's still a historic moment. This doesn't happen every day. The senator doesn't stand and say guilty or not guilty on most pieces of legislation, right, and confirmations.
You know, Molly, I think this is going the way that so many people expected it to, but we did hear some senators on the Republican side say that some wrongdoing was done by the president, more than we saw in the House. In the end, the fallout here, should the president be acquitted as it is expected, sort of what is the fallout and the repercussions going forward, if any?
Well, I hate to say it, but it sort of remains to be seen. And when asked, you know, will this impact the election, again, that's something we're going to find out in the fall of this year. Because really, how closely voters have been tracking the impeachment trial, that also is unclear. What I've heard from sources on Capitol Hill, though, is normally, you know, when there's historic legislation, Obamacare, controversial nominations, Justice Kavanaugh, the switchboards light up in the Senate offices.
Right.
That hasn't happened as much this go-round. So really, that's a question that remains to be seen.
All right, a lot of time to go. Molly, we appreciate the insight. Thank you.
You're welcome.